we want to talk about right now is New Testament reliability. Are the New Testament manuscripts, the 27 books of the New Testament, are they historically reliable? Is this really what the first century church wrote down? A lot of people will say, no, you know, these documents are legends and they were copied later on and things of that sort. And so we want to deal with that. What we're going to do is we're going to take the New Testament documents and match them up with other documents from ancient writings. I'm just going to use a couple other examples. So first we'll look at the New Testament. Now, with the New Testament, you have over 5,700 ancient copies in Greek. You also have over 9,000 copies in ancient Latin and Syriac and other ancient languages as well. All total, I believe F.F. Bruce listed the total number of copies of the New Testament, over 24,000. Okay? Now, that's a lot of copies that we can compare, handwritten ancient copies. Homer's Iliad is in second place of all ancient literature with only 643 copies. So that's a significant drop, yet Homer's Iliad second place. Plato, nobody doubts what Plato wrote. We only have 7 copies of Plato's writing, 7 ancient handwritten copies. So with the New Testament, you have all these copies that can be compared with one another. Bruce Metzger of Princeton University, he said that there was 99.5% agreement between the copies. You have variants, different ways to spell a word, some copyist errors, but when you look for significant discrepancies, there's only 0.5%. Again, Homer's Iliad is in second place with 95% accuracy, and they don't even deal with Plato's on that, probably because there were probably 7 copies written by the same copyist. But second place is 95%. Now, that looks pretty close, but in reality, what we're saying here is in the New Testament, only 5 words out of every 1,000 are called into question, whereas with Homer's Iliad, 50 words out of every 1,000 are called into question. In other words, the New Testament is 10 times more reliable. The New Testament manuscripts are 10 times more reliable than the second best of all ancient literature, Homer's Iliad. And by the way, when you only have 5 words out of every 1,000 that are called into question, and you have well over 20,000 copies, just by comparing these copies, we can figure out who got it wrong. And this is why most scholars, most New Testament scholars acknowledge that the New Testament we have today was exactly what was originally written. And we'll have to take a look at some of the individual books to argue that it was not only copied that way originally, but it was actually copied by an eyewitness or somebody who knew an eyewitness. So we'll look at some individual books to deal with that. Now you could take somebody else, throw somebody else into the mix. By the way, Alexander the Great. And what you find with Alexander the Great, you've got to go 300 to 400 years after he lived before you have any significant manuscripts written about him. And you might have a few fragments on him dating within 100 or 200 years from when he lived. But to get significant information about him like we have about Jesus in these ancient New Testament manuscripts, you've got to go a good 300 to 400 years. Yet no one's going to have doubts about the life of Alexander the Great. No one's going to doubt that Plato wrote his writings. No one's going to doubt Homer's Iliad. Why then do they doubt the New Testament? It's because they're using a double standard, a standard against the New Testament that is stricter than against all other ancient literature. By the way, the oldest fragment we have from the New Testament dates to about 25 to 35 years after it was written. So you get about 25 to 35 years. It's a fragment of John chapter 18, the John Rylands papyri. With Homer's Iliad, the gap is 500 years. The earliest copy we have is written 500 years later. Plato, 1,200 years later. Now just think about all the changes that could have occurred to Plato's writings in 1,200 years, yet we only have 7 copies, we've got this huge long gap, and nobody questions that Plato wrote that. So it's amazing that people will question the New Testament when it has far more evidence going for it than any other first century document.